Yeah, check it out, man. It's your boy Akon, and right now you're tuned in to Beyond the Talent.
Hello, we're sitting down with a man that I think needs no introduction. Songwriter, singer, producer, record breaker. How you doing?
What's up, babe?
Akon's in the building, y'all.
Yes, ma'am. I wanna make up right now, nah. I wanna make up right now, nah. Wish we never broke up right now, nah. We need to link up right now, nah.
So, your dad was in the music, a musician.
Mm-hmm.
You grew up around a lot of music. Did you always know, like, as a kid?
No, as a kid, music wasn't even an option for me. That's
really?
Actually the last thing I wanted to do.
What did you want to do?
Anything else but music.
Really?
Absolutely.
It was, why?
It was, well, I mean, it was surrounded. I was surrounded by music, so that's not something I wanted to. I wanted to branch off away from it, you know.
Really?
Yeah, and it just, I guess, destiny brought me right back to it.
I was gonna say, do you believe in destiny?
Yeah, sure do.
Wow. So, from your music, you've done so much. It seems like the trials and tribulations have all, you've benefited from it. Like you've made it work. It's almost like a silver lining.
Well, I mean, that's the lessons that you learn in life. You know, everything happens, it's gonna be obstacles that come, and it's pretty much in how you deal with it. You know, every situation that comes to you, positive or negative, and majority of the time it's gonna be negative, because the negative always outweigh the positive. You gotta figure out how to take the best out of that negative situation to your benefit.
Nice.
Yeah.
So it seems like you're very decisive, and you obviously had made the decision to do music.
Mm-hmm.
When? What was the thought process?
Oh, well, actually, it all stemmed from me just trying everything. My main goal, I just wanted to be rich. That was the goal. And it just so happened that it was so many other opportunities to get rich quicker. And I kind of wanted to, I wanted it so bad, I kind of, you know, experimented on some of my opportunities and ended up getting locked up. And then while I was locked up, that's when it all came together. Everything came together.
Can't wait to get out and move forward with my life.
Slowed me down. It was actually a blessing for me, because if the route where I was going, honestly, had I continued that, I wouldn't know where I'd be today. So, and it was just obvious to me, because sitting up in there, I knew this wasn't the life that I wanted to do or spend for the rest of my life. But at the end of the day, I knew I was between a rock and a hard place, because now getting out with a criminal history, you couldn't work in a Fortune 500 company or even have the opportunities to become rich.
That's so, why I love the entertainment
at
industry.
That moment, it was like, okay, well, I'm great at music. I love to do it. I would do it even without getting paid. So that's when I created a 10-year plan in there, and it came out and started executing on it.
A 10-year plan?
Yeah.
What was in the plan?
Well, the top goal was to work with Michael Jackson, which I was reaching for the skies at the time.
I was
reaching for the
skies. Really?
So I said, look, I'm just going to go for as far as I can reach. If I can commit to at least 10% of what I'm trying to do, then I should be good.
Wow.
Yeah, and it just all started coming together, man. And that 10-year plan ended up being, you know, executed within 5 years. So then from there, it was just like, okay, now let's turn other tables and figure out other areas to become successful at.
When you first hit, the internet was not what it is today.
No, none.
How do you feel about the internet kind of changing the game?
I love what the internet is. Actually, the internet, believe it or not, is a tool. I mean, now it's like, we have more power over our own career because of the internet. Before, you know, the record companies and all the other major corporations would have that advantage over you, because without their system, you couldn't flourish. Now, without their system, you can create your own system over the internet. And online, you can create your own community. Not that, but even when it goes down to database, now you can actually target exactly who's with you, who's looking for you, who's not. And then you have an audience to market to. You know, before you didn't have that. The database alone is the most important part of the internet that people don't take full advantage of.
Sounds like you do.
Oh, absolutely. That was my main goal. You know, that's all we focus on.
Now, do you ever have a moment where you say, oh my God, God bless the idiot that didn't pick up Lady Gaga?
Nah. absolutely. Well, I mean, because I think everything happens for a reason. I think she went through all of that. And I'm glad it happened that way, because by the time she came around to me, she was already seasoned as far as what to expect and what not to expect more than anything. Because sometimes when you get a brand new artist and you're in a position where, okay, now you're signing to a brand that's already physically established, they feel like that the work is not necessary because you put all the work in for them. When all actuality, all you do is open up those doors for them to, you know, to walk through. So, but she was in a position where she actually understood how hard it take to get there, because she's been signed 5 times before I signed her. So she knew a record deal wasn't like, because a lot of people, a lot of kids out there, you know, they get these demos and send, and they figure out once they sign it, okay, boom, I'm here now, I made it. Not even realizing that contract is just the beginning of the turmoil that's to come, you know? Yeah.
What would you say to somebody that wants to do what you did but doesn't feel like they have the advantages?
Well, you gotta find your advantages. That's the key, because everybody, I mean, we all come from different places, different backgrounds, and we all have different strategic ways of how we want to get to where we're going. But first, you got to know where you're going in all process. So you got to know how to get there. Like, all I am an example to what I like to do and what my dream is. But ultimately, everybody have their own dream, and there's different ways to get there. You just got to pay attention to your surroundings and find the best way to get there. But you just can't give up, because everybody wants to be rich and famous. So get in line. And you gotta be more patient than anything, because you can't be so quick to judge, I mean, rush into decisions. You gotta be very patient, know what you want, and then just go after it. And then when it comes, it comes. But it really comes, so be ready for it, you know?
And I don't believe in plan Bs. Did you have a plan B?
No, I never believed in plan Bs either.
Very good. Don't have a plan B.
Plan B, you already planning to fail.
Exactly. Where's the faith?
You already planning to fail. I mean, there's no way out. This is the road. By any means, we gotta get there. Ain't no other way.
What is the thing that gets you out of bed in the morning? I mean, with all of your success, you could just be like, I mean, you can retire. What is the mantra? What is in your head that keeps you going?
Well, I mean, you know, just staying focused to that goal. You know, just trying to, you know, I really want to be able to achieve that final goal. You know, you're right. I could relax and not ever have to work again, but then it's boring. I'd be sitting home doing nothing. You know what I mean? I can't. I just have to be doing something. You know, because it's never about me. I always never looked at it like it was about me. If that's the case, then I could retire. But I want to be able to, you know, make sure that I break the chain for my family name. I want me, or the work that I put in, to be able to at least secure another 3-4 generations. So they won't have to say, they can look at their, you know, great-great-great-grandfather and say, you know what, because of him is why we own this empire and why we can continue to, you know, move forward without having to worry about where the next dollar is going to come from, or why my son or daughter is out in the streets because she don't have, you know what I mean? So, you know, so that's the main goal.
And how does it feel knowing that you have millions of people inspired by you and motivated by you? How does it feel?
That's a great feeling, because now you feel like you're actually, you know, a contribution, you know? And being a contribution is a great thing, because most people don't realize how much they actually do contribute. So that's a beautiful feeling.
Well, thank you so much for sitting with me. You were powerful and inspirational and positive. I love it.
Absolutely.
And I'm going to Malta.
Just let me know where you're going.
Thanks for watching Beyond the Talent. I'm Jania Frederick, and this is Akon.
Absolutely.